Hello, good morning. Let's do sports news now here on New Day. My name is Yao Ofusula. But in today's sports news, just a twist to it, because we have an interview with Michael Sarpong, who plays his football for the Young African Sporting Club in Tanzania. Michael Sarpong has been telling us about his career, how he started at Liberty Professionals, all through Dreams FC, went to Rayon Sport in Rwanda, and then to the Young Africans in Tanzania. He spoke to me in an exclusive interview.
On TV3 now, your time at Liberty and also at Dreams. What memories do you have of those times when you were playing the Ghana Premier League?
Thank you. It was a great experience down there, because looking back to where I came from, to Liberty, from the junior side to the premier side, I actually had a great time. And then from there to Dreams FC, we went back to the first division due to some problems, but then we came back to the Premier League. And then before I left Ghana, it's been a great experience so far.
How do you rate the quality of the Ghana Premier League, the one that you played in? I'm sure, you know, since you've come back, you've seen a few games now. Has it become more competitive in your opinion?
I think now it's more competitive, because I've been following it at the league, so where I was, I'm still following the Ghana League because it's my home league. So I think it's a bit competitive than it was previously. Yeah.
Now, let's. You made a move out of Ghana. I mean, you went to Rwanda, you went to play and all that. Now, I mean, let's do a comparative analysis of football in Ghana and football in Rwanda. We both know that Rwanda is not a country that's known for football. So when you were going there, what were you expecting?
I went there because there wasn't football in Ghana when the announced expose came out. So I was supposed to go and play in Europe, but then I was refused the visa here. So my agent called me and was like, why don't you try and play like 6 months in Rwanda? So I'm like, yeah, let's do this. So I went there and then it started. But the football there is not that like as in Ghana, but then they have good facilities over there. The pitches and stuff, cameras are like okay in Rwanda. So I mean, I thought I could make some good videos out here, and then in the next few months or years, I can just move on to my career.
How good was that experience in Rwanda?
It was great. It was worth it. And then I ended up being like a huge figure in Rwanda. I mean, it's God's plan. You never know where God will make you shine. So I might say it's by the grace of God. Things moved very smoothly down there for me.
Now, I mean, you were talking about how, you know, unfamiliar football is over there. I mean, like I said earlier, comparatively, the sort of fans you see at stadiums in Ghana, and in comparison to the sort of fans you saw in Kigali and Gitarama and all those cities that you played in Rwanda, how would you rate the level of enthusiasm of the fans, you know, across the cities that you played there?
I realized that they love football so much. When I was young here, I realized like when Hearts is playing, Kotoko is playing, the fans come to the stadium like so much. But then growing up, the love fade away. But when I got to Rwanda, I realized like even if the team is losing, it's winning, the fans are always like following the club wherever they go. So I think the interest in football over there is higher than in Ghana right now.
Now you mentioned that you became a huge figure in Rwanda. Did you win any awards? What made you that very popular person aside from the football?
I mean, it was just football. Right. I got like the best player of the season with my club. Right. I got 3 player of the month awards, and I ended up being the team of the century in Rwanda.
Away from Rwanda, what was the career path like for you? You know, when you were at Rwanda, what, you know, after you wanted to move on, what happened?
I actually had a deal to sign in China, but then due to the COVID situation, so I had to come back to Ghana, and then the lockdown happened, so I had to move. My agents called me like there's a club in Norway wanted to sign me, so I went there, but then the questions didn't go through. So my club in Rwanda didn't accept the contract terms. So I need to come back to Rwanda and then finish my contract.
So many impediments in your career that, you know, it could have been better than it is now, from what you're saying. How does that make you feel?
I think I've never regretted anything in my career so far. I see it all as an experience. Maybe when I think if God says today is for you, it's going to be yours. So I'm always being patient and just waiting for the right time.
So after that move, you know, the move that didn't work out for the, to go to Norway, and then you went back to Rwanda for Rayon Sport. What happened?
I had 4 months to end my contract in Rwanda, so I waited till it's over and I moved to Tanzania.
Okay. Now, Tanzania is a football mad country. Yeah. You know, we see pictures, we see videos, and all of that, and knowing that you play for one of the biggest clubs in Tanzania, how does that make you feel?
I feel great. I feel like excited working in town, playing for young Africans. Like the way they see football in Tanzania is way different than all African countries. Like the passion is like A1. Like it's so I don't know how to describe it, but they love football so much in Tanzania.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now looking at the size and magnitude of a club like Young Africans, what club in Ghana can you attribute the size and magnitude of Yanga to?
I think it's a traditional team. It's an old club, like compared to Great Olympics and Heart of Oak. But then it comes with how the team is being handled at the moment. And then the level at which younger Africans is right now is can't be compared to across the world in terms of like right now, as I'm talking to you now. So I think over there it's a bit higher right now than in Ghana.
Right. How many Ghanaians are in the Tanzanian Premier League? I mean, the last time I was, one of my colleague journalists was talking about the Ghanaians and how well all of you are doing in the Tanzanian League, which they are hugely appreciative of. But how many are you and how's the football going? Why are you guys so incredibly popular in Tanzania?
We are two Ghanaians in my club right now. Right. Lamine, he's our captain. He's been there for almost like, this is his second year in the club. Right. And then there's one guy too playing for Namungo, and one guy too playing for Simba. He's called Bernard Morrison. Right. Yeah. So the fans made you play football. Mm-hmm. Like the fans make football entertaining. So when you see them in the stands, you want to do more for them to always like keep chanting your name. So that's the motivation, if I could say. That's the motivation for us.
Now, Yanga and Simba games are always very, very feisty. Yeah. You know, they're like, over the past 2 years, it's become one of the greatest rivalries in African football. You played in it. How tough is it?
It was very tough. I mean, the fans do everything. The fans love football so much. It's always about Young Africans and Simba. I finished, nothing more, nothing less. So people even lost their lives during that game. So, I mean, you should know how tough that game is. And then you as a player, you need to be like mentally psyched for going to that game. It's never an easy game. So, I mean, you have to be yourself and be strong.
Michael, let's talk now about the trophy you just won at Yanga. I mean, you know, every footballer's dream is to play consistently and win. Mm. You're playing consistently. You've just won, and you know, I'm sure you're certainly looking forward to more things ahead.
Yeah, we actually went to this tournament to just be the champions, and then God being so good to us, we won it. We are actually first on the league table right now. We're still unbeaten. Yeah. So our main goal is to get the league, get the FA Cup, get this Mapping Music Cup too. So one down, yeah, and then two more to go. We are still trying to work hard, keep ourselves together, and then get the dream work.
Now, I'll go back and ask again. What is Yanga doing right in the Tanzanian Premier League? Is it a rich owner? Is it like what is really happening at the club?
The players are like 100% motivated. We've been kept at a very comfortable environment. We are based in a very good place. It's far from the city though, but then it's a very organized and a very nice apartment for. And then everything that we need to, they give it to us. So the players are always motivated and psyched very well.
I'm sure you've learned a few words of Swahili.
Yeah. Like when they say Mambo means how are you, you respond poor, I'm fine.
That's all you know.
A little bit.
All right, let's move on now. I mean, has the dream to try to play in Europe died, or is this still alive for you now that you're at Yanga?
Yeah, it's still alive. The future is bright. Maybe you never know, it might happen soon. Or
let's talk a bit about, you know, national team duties. You've not really had a taste of it, you know, in your football career, and I'm sure it's definitely something you're looking forward to, isn't it?
So bad. I'm looking forward to it so bad. And I pray maybe it's not my time yet. So I keep praying to God and I keep working hard. When it's my time and then God says this is your time, Michael, it will be seen.
A very final word. We've seen many of you guys, you know, footballers who play across the African continent. You know, usually it gets very tough, then you decide to come back home, and then, you know, the trajectory never really gets to that level. Mm-hmm. How are you looking to, one, improve yourself, and two, get your career going so you get to the very highest level of your football game?
Thank you. It is about taking good care of yourself and then being closer to God. What keeps me going is like my family is always behind me with their prayers and their support. So whatever I have in mind, I share with them and they help me. I'm still young. I might not know much. So I always seek for advices for people who are older than me so I can know what to do in my career. And so far, so good. I think I'm on the right path. So I just need to just keep protecting myself and just being good to myself, being honest to myself. That's going to keep me there.
Right. Michael, thank you very much for joining us this morning on New Day.
You're welcome, boss. Have a good day. Bye. Oh.